Gonna open it. Here we go.
Pat's found a case. It's makeup.
Is it?
Yeah.
I wonder how it look on my face.
Can finally get all those blemishes.
Yeah. I wonder how old it is.
It's metal, so it must be pretty old. Obviously.
I wonder what that means right there. Almost like a face. I think there's a face in there. Makeup, anyone?
That's weird.
Well, I'm here with a little prospector, Lens E. And this we detected for, an hour and a half. And the last thing she got was this nice mason jar lid and a nail. But I did find...
Mason jar was about a foot in the ground.
Yeah, I did find this. She said it's a cloth-covered button, which I believe she found that the other day. I found, don't know what that is, don't know what this is. But the find of the day, it was a makeup case. In my opinion, unless she's gonna pull something out of the, pull something out of her sack over there.
No, I did get that cool zipper though.
Oh yeah.
Hold on. Here was the thing. I can't figure out what it was. It's some kind of top or something, but it's some kind of weird metal that was ringing up like crazy.
Okay. So it's hot out today, and we're both spent. So. What's our motto?
If you can't find it, just walk away. Hello again, peoples. I'm here at this old church. They've actually got supports on the other side. It is leaning. I don't know if you can see it over here. I'll take you around there later, but it's 20% lean and 80% beef over there. So I've got my first goodie for the day. And it is, got my lawn and garden gloves today. A little button. Pretty happy with that this rainy morning. Hey folks, got another find. This is like my fifth. Either live round shell casing or strange looking projectile object. So here is another one. I don't know who comes and shoots our guns at church. I think this might be a Monticello thing. Got my first coin for today. And I just popped out of the hole there, so I wanted to wait till I had it on camera to see if it's a wheat sin or not. It wasn't very deep. Stinky memorial. All right, I got something else. Kind of over here by this old cemetery. Man, not really 100% sure on this one. I have to take it home and clean it up some more, see what it is. It's raining on me, so I might have to go get in the car. What's up? I'm back again. This one was kind of deep. It's the first find I have that hopefully is not another shell casing shotgun. I think it might be a button. It's a button. Heck yeah. I was about to leave too. I want to look around some more. My husband is probably going to wring my neck. But sometimes it is just worth it. Well, it must be Button Wednesday. I think I have gotten another button. No, it's a dime. It's just a dime. Oh, man. Hey. I didn't shoot a conclusion video for yesterday, so I figured I'd do that now. I'm about to go out on the river with my AT Pro, see what we can't find. My first time out on the river with it. We'll see how I do. Well, anyway, I hate when I do that. I look like a blind person looking around. I need to actually not look at the phone and look at the table. Okay, so There are my pull tabs. I've got a few pull tabs. Got a modern penny and a modern dime. Got lots of ammo rounds out there. Even got a live one. All kinds of different calibers and sizes going on there. I also found this piece of red. I'm probably going to murder the word, but I think it's shirt. Some red shirt. This is not native to my area. So when we see it, I know it was brought here by probably a Native American. And they usually look like they've been kind of warped. Like, I don't know if you can see the little chips and stuff in it. I love finding red shirt because I know it's not from around here. Got a few nails. Usually I'm set up to tune out nails. I think I did pick this one up independently. It was kind of big. The rest of them were just in holes that I found with the pinpointers with other things. Got this. I think this could possibly be a lipstick. It looked a little bit different. It looks like that piece slides down in it. And there's also, I don't know if you can see it, but there's some red right in there. And there's some more red right in that hole. So I'm wondering if it's not some lipstick in here. It's obviously got squished. Also made me think maybe a pen. So if you know what this is, you can please leave it in the comments. Something though, it's definitely something. And the also got some spent rounds and big lead chunks out there. Always cool when I think I find these. And the found this near the fence. I found another one and I eyeballed a third laying on top of the ground. All in that same area. I think it may have to do something with fencing or maybe a tent for funerals. I'm not 100%. So if you know that one, you can also leave it in the comments. Ugh, it's kind of gross. And these showstoppers are these two old buttons. Been told I say button funny, but I don't care. They both have writing. This one is super fine. I don't know if you see the super fine up there. And then it says London. Now, I don't know if it's true, but I heard if they say London or somewhere not the U.S., that they were before 1830 because we didn't have factories to keep up with supply and demand then. But I don't know how true that is. And then the other one I have, you can probably only see the gilt on it, but it says super gilt. See the gilt right there? It's upside down though. Turn it around. And you might be able to make out the gilt. Yeah, I can see it. It's right there. So I got a super gilt. I was happy they had writing and they weren't just a plain old flat button. And I'm a little sick still, but I'm gonna head out on the river and focus here. See what we can't find. What's up, what's up? I decided to X-nay on that tube and I'm gonna let the boys go. And I'm gonna stay here and detect my absolute favorite spot, which is, I'm not getting up on the house site today. The house site's over in here. You can see that little rock wall. It's very old, one of the oldest in the county. It is early 1700s, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Big Indian, the river is right down there. For some reason, it's really bright, so I can't. You can't see it on my phone, even though I can see it in person. I finally found the well over here. I'm going to be concentrating, I think, more over here in this well area. I want to try to not get 100 ticks today. That's going to be the main goal. I might get a little bit of this area where it's not so grown up. It's a big property I've got access to, and I'm just gonna go around and see what I can find. This is a frustrating spot, having to dig out a lot of trash first, but it is the honey hole of the county if I can ever find anything good. We'll see y'all in a little bit when I find some. Got the elusive Turkey Thomas finally on camera. We're about to go. Tubing and the water's moving really fast today, so I guess that Thomas is gonna have to take off now, or Austin's gonna have to grab that tree. Y'all be careful. River's way up. That's where the mills used to be. There's a little island. Get out of the way of the tree. island in the middle. River goes this way, that way. Mills were over here. The property where I'm detecting is right there. Bye, Turkey Thomas.
If we're not back in 2 hours, call the police.
I'm gonna wait at least 6 hours before I call the police.
No.
Yeah.
See you there in an hour.
See you later. What's up, ladies and gents? Look what I have got. I got me some Buddy Holly glasses. And I got a lot of trash to dig out of this site before I find a lot. They've been shooting guns, drinking, doing all kind of stuff down here for many, many years since. But I like the Buddy Holly glasses. Pretty freaking awesome. I don't think I tore them up because I could not find the rest of it no matter how much I searched. What's with these homies missing my girl? What's up? At a super old house in Covington. Got my first target here and looks like it could be a coin. And it's not. It is the back of a screw or something. Oh well, we'll keep looking. River Rat Pat thinks he has a box of something special down there. We'll find out in a minute. And I have got something. I didn't want to wipe it off yet, so I'm hoping it, I'm not going to make a dummy out of myself and it's trash, but I could kind of look at this side and see that maybe it's a button. I say button funny, apparently. I think it is. Oh, it is! And it's kind of cool looking.
It's a button or a coin?
It's a button.
Nice.
I have to get it cleaned up and get another view of it.
I got a square rock.
Was that the box?
That can't be what was. Yeah, but that's not what's.
Keep searching. Maybe it was the marker.
I thought it was one of those locks that moves. It does. It's got stuff on the back.
That is freaking cool. You better double check that
hole. I will, but it was pushed way back up under here. Doesn't it look like it goes to a lock?
Yeah.
Wow.
That looks really old. Let me go back and show you show your other awesome target over here. I think it's fair for everybody to know it took you so long to dig up. There we go. Got my next cool find. I wanted to clean it up so I didn't look stupid because it didn't really look like familiar to me there. I think it's some kind of like mill token. And it says good for 5 in trade with the 197 on it. I'll try to look up a little more about tokens. Don't really know a lot about those yet. But pretty cool. You want to show up your finds first?
Oh, yes. Here we have my find of the day. A trunk lock.
Plate.
Trunk lock plate. And we have an actual lock. It's just a
Acme.
Vintage lock. A vintage Baby Gerber top, a cool brass buckle, head stamp, and a big hoe, and whatever she called this thing, goes to the top of a lamp to hold the shade on. And the rest is,
I bet that was that other thing we found that one time that we, said was a fishing weight.
Yeah.
Oh, a modern penny too.
No, I found this. I don't think Lindsay sold on it, but a Civil War button. I mean, not button. Civil War bullet fired.
Everybody's got buttons on the brain today.
Yep. All
because
right. So,
we'll go with find of the day first.
Dun, dun.
We actually cleaned the button up, and it is a Georgia Civil War button. You can see my camera doesn't want to focus on it, of course.
That's the real thing. That helps. Folks.
There we go. That's better. That's better. Yeah. You can see the man right here and the hunk of mountain.
It is a bona fide button.
From the Civil War.
And then she found a crackhead's supply.
I did.
Or it could be a diabetes.
It could patient. Be the morphine from the war.
That's a good, yeah.
Yeah.
Very much so.
It's probably not, but I couldn't help. Got a buckle, nice little buckle. Brass buckle, suspender. I think that's a suspender clip.
That's it, you're right.
Suspender clip.
It's about the size of it.
Got a mill token here.
Yes.
What I think is a mill token. Got all excited, thought I had a coin, but it's still a coin, I guess. I got this, gosh, I thought it was a coin for sure.
Still not sure what it is.
Yes, still not sure.
This is nice.
Yes, I got
that's somebody's.
A butter knife.
It's gonna be made out of copper or something. I mean, the patina, yeah. It could be silver.
It could be.
Silver turn or no? Silver.
I don't think silver is supposed to come out of the ground all silvery.
Oh, okay.
Like it's.
Shows you what I
mean. I could be wrong though. We had to clean that up.
Found some good horse stuff.
Yeah. That's good horse tack. Got two pieces of china and a really old piece of glass. But you can see the holes
bubbles.
And bubbles and bumpiness of it. Old glass.
Oh wait, I did find some
and I got a hand hoe.
I found some vintage
diaper rash cream to go with this Gerber baby food.
Those babies having problems.
Might here. Need to take that home.
There's some babies. We did each find a half a horseshoe.
Half a horseshoe.
Hers is bigger.
Of course.
Yeah. It has a little
pony shoe.
Pony shoe.
And I got all that metal. I got a old hose part.
That might be
mason
something.
Jar lid.
I think that's gonna turn out to be something once you clean it up.
I have nothing to clean anything that nasty, but we'll try. And that's pretty much it. We'll leave these beautiful finds. Big day.
Big
the
day.
House is 1835. That's getting out of the way. Camera shot today. I probably should.
1835.
She said 1835 is old. The first dwelling out here was late 1700s. Undisclosed location. We do not giving up our spot. Well, we'll see y'all next time. This closing video is already at 4 minutes.
See y'all.
Later. We're back out here at the same house we were yesterday, and I just got my first big something that was not absolute trash. Looks like a piece to that lock plate Pat found yesterday.
A little prospector doesn't know, but what she knows, I got this kit. It's one of those metal testing kits. I was trying to see. What's what? I can't tell. Because I don't see anything changing color except that. And that's from the silver spoon or something. It's even got initials on it. Alright, little prospector is over there. She just found a button in this nice old house. Undisclosed location. Just wanted to share with y'all a couple of things I eyeballed today with my great skills. One of them, an Easter egg. Does that count for anything? Has nothing in it. And I eyeballed that. Woohoo! Her AT Pros. I told her there wasn't anything in the front yard, and she runs over here and finds a button.
Phew, for a minute there, I thought I was going to dig nothing but junk today, but I've got a flat button. It was super duper deep, too. I actually had to start digging that way. It's got the shank on it. Let's hear it for the shank being intact. Get it cleaned up when I get home and see if it has some writing like London or Kalu. nice flat button with the shank.
Yes, it is. What's on the front, anything?
Nope. Not that I can tell yet.
Comma
4. It might have some writing like my other ones did on the back, but
comma,
I have to clean it.
Comma 4 button.
Yep. I think they were all just about comma 4 buttons back then.
Well, good for you. AT Pro is just a button finding machine.
It is. It likes the buttons.
It likes buttons and bullets.
It was deep too.
That was deep. Look at that hole.
Fish it all out, but it was ringing in the 70s, 80s.
That's
so I knew it was something
that's 6 to 8 inches deep. Very good. It's like pulling teeth trying to get her away from it. Last dig. She said, okay. She's gonna hide, put it on mute. I wish we could get in that big field, but it's just too high. That grass is too high. There's a cemetery back there somewhere. She doesn't want to quit. See? She just keeps on going. She got a shovel as big as she is. All right, another day. I was forced into coming over here to metal detect again by the little prospector. We both found lots of iron, big piles. We were kind of in a, well, she did find a horseshoe amongst that. I guess we're in like where they burn stuff, I don't know. But anyway, her good finds are, number one, part of a clock, or lock, excuse me. Locker clock, modern penny, modern nickel, and a
flat button.
A flat what?
Button. A double.
She found a button.
A double gilt flat button.
And lots of stuff. Others. Some shells. Antenna. Oh, this is all.
I think that's maybe a lantern. Not 100% sure on that.
Anyhow.
There's a screw hole there, so obviously, no, is it? Yeah, so something screwed on right
there.
So
if you know what it is, leave it in the comments. Same here, just a bunch of
I found a chain,
iron.
Too.
Oh. It's holding out. I found a buckle with no writing on it. This little thing. Don't know what it is. And a silver spoon that has initials on it. Michael Jackson. Oh.
We're going to give Pat find of the day.
It's
so
silver.
So he actually got something silver.
It's 0.800 silver. It's not 0.9.
Oh, it's not 925.
No. And I eyeballed a few things. A feather. A Easter egg. And a fidget. So, anyway. Dig the...
Deep beep.
Deep beep.
New motto,
dig the deep beep. If your shovel will go that far.
Double gilt, that's what it is. It's double gilt.
So that means it's double value?
It's double the quality. It's definitely the, besides the Civil War button, it's definitely the coolest button.
Who's up to the thing? Nice.
It's double, D-O-U-B-L-E.